not just political ambassadors. Passport, visa, delegate to automation, please. You don't have to spend your talented time, your brilliant foreign policy, like IAS, I mean, they're all brilliant people. Leverage them for something you network, not with Indian diaspora or Indians, you know, NRIs like me, but go out into the mainstream white population, American population, French population, and promote India positively. Which means you've got to learn what they do. You have to be in their shoes. By the way, that's working. The appointments are coming in a way where it's very exciting to see. We have a new consulate in Atlanta, and the three consul generals that have come, Ajit Kumar first, Nagesh Singh, who is now part of the diplomatic, something what he does here in Delhi, and right now we have Swati Kulkarni, a medical doctor who went into foreign service, brilliant young lady, and they're all now wiring with the American diasporas, American events, American etc., because otherwise you remain ethnocentric, totally isolated. One way to integrate ourselves is to use our diplomatic core and our diaspora, not from ethnic to ethnic, but ethnic to mainstream, which is very important, I think, so personally. We have a strong growing soft power. The only soft power that's missing, surprisingly, is that what happened to Japan? Remember, Japan in my younger days, in the late 40s, early 50s, was a laughing stock. Cheap products came from Japan. No quality assurance. Japan invested in quality, which is again in education, we talked about quality, I think all of us talked about. And Japan became number one brand in the world, which means responsibility lies not with the government alone, but with our private sector and public sector. To create world-class quality standards should be global. They embraced global standards to export the market. Deming, who was a statistician from New York University, became their advisor. Think about that one. Who transformed the nation? South Koreans followed. They took over from Japan. Chinese are now gunning for quality. Same process. China is not a low-quality producer. It is all-quality producer. And they will exit the low-end market, as Japan did, by JETRO, licensing. How can I think policy can guide the private sector to aspire to become, and the best soft power of a nation arises from its products or from its people. That's very important. So I think we have to leverage that. I tell you, we have a strong military. In the wars that you take place between the dogfights, American pilots are absolutely amazed how we are outsmarting them. And they are considered top in their mind, at least. We outsmart in the Navy engagements, both with the Australian Navy and the American Navy, which again they can't think. They are very high tech, but they don't have the experiential-based common sense quite often. You rely too much on technology. Whereas we are a hybrid between the two. We have, at least in the aircraft, we know all weapons of the world. America mostly their weapons of the world. So you can use the MiG technologies or the French technologies or the British or whatever they are. I'm very amazed how well our military is respected by their counterparts in the world. But we have never praised them. We have never packaged our soldiers and made them heroes. Huge force. Diplomats the same way, as I mentioned. Diaspora the same way. I think we need to think out of the box. So I'm sorry again to take a little longer time because I did not know the timing of the presentation. So what is going to happen is that India, which was a domestically isolated economy under license Raj, is now becoming globally integrated. And from a regional diplomacy like the SAARC or Southeast Asia, we have to become diplomatic emphasis or influence on a global basis. In the world discussions, can India show up? Our people have showed up because many of the major agencies, heads of the agencies or one level below are all Indians. World Bank is full of Indians. United Nations is full of Indians. But can we be at the table, not on the side of the table, is very key. I think it's all doable. It's a question of what we do. So now we come to Telangana. I will remove many of the slides because of the time. This will be available for display or distribution. So I will remove about all this stuff because that's fine, because of the time. India will come up this way. I'm very positive about the future. Now, how can Telangana take advantage? Which means there's a race between states. I learned from Singapore, smaller you are as a city state, the more you have less constraints. You can do better. I have been involved in Singapore's positioning, repositioning several cycles now. Singapore was aspiring to become a manufacturing hub. And as an outsider, you say, how can manufacturing be sustainable even? Because you don't have cheap labor, which is one factor of production. You don't have a local market. 2.5 million does not make a market in the world. And of course, you don't have the third key element that is there pretty much as a manufacturing. You give incentives, people will come, they will rip you off and they will walk out. It'll be next Malaysia. Nobody knew China's rise. So instead we said, can you become a distribution country? Four flows, flow of products, you make money on them. Flow of people, Changi Airport, we make money on them. Flow of capital, private equity, because there was no stock market we could create, and flow of information. We have now added flow of culture, because Singapore was money, 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 time. Next generation, who is so affluent, does not relate to the nation. Military service is not enough. So we said, soften up as a country. You cannot be so disciplinarian. Allow rock bands to come. Have rock band in the library, which is totally contradictory. Think like that. It worked very well. People are happy because you need that political power of people's happiness with the current government, whatever they are. And we have added the flow of research, very key. Not university affiliations, but picking up a research team from someplace and nurture and mentor them. And I'll tell you, I just went to University of Singapore University of Technology and Design, MIT collaboration about 10 years. And I went to see how it operates. Wanted to look at one called iTrust, small iTrust. It is basically major cyber attacks will be now on installations, not on nations or population. Your power plants, your telephone networks. So this does a cyber warfare where the Department of Defense from America shows up, of course their own defense, and they play the cyber attack games on key installations for power and water system. Amazing. Now who runs that? An Indian person, scientist from Purdue University, who gave up his career there to become a full-time director. Our talent is there. We have all the capabilities. So I think we are quite blessed in that way, and therefore, how can we leverage this? So let me go to the slide in my handout so I cannot turn around and look over there because it upsets the microphone here, right? So let me just show you. How can Telangana level, which is very key, become a global hub for not just IT services, but all professional services. One of your largest employers here in accounting is Ernst & Young, will be followed by Deloitte. This is the accounting capital almost emerging out of nowhere. They figured out this is a good place. So will be true for health services. Legal services is the next one where the BPOs will come. What began with the call centers and IT BPO and IT services, sitting on the board of Wipro for several years, who learn about all these technologies. So I would generalize to professional services and target some key ones. Second one, attract global defense companies, as we have done. This will become one of the well-known defense capitals of the world, or India especially. F-16 fighter plane, I've been advocating for about 7 or 8 years in America. It's 2 generations old. Lockheed does not have to keep it. Can you outsource it? And it is likely to come in India, whether it's in Bangalore or in Hyderabad is a debate, and Hyderabad seems to be winning the F-16. It has at least $50 billion of value left for all of the MRO, maintenance, repair, operations is still left there. Even if you don't sell a new plane, it has that much value.